Spike Jonze's 2013 film Her takes place in a technologically advanced Los Angeles that mirrors our society today. Among the many faces on the street, we follow Theodore Twombly, a lonely, introverted, and depressed man who works as a professional writer at a letter-writing company. The movie opens with a close-up shot of Theodore, visibly out of focus with the surroundings, as he writes an imitated love letter for somebody he has no relationship with. His daily routine is one that is gloomy and isolating, and it's a choice that he makes for himself.
Play a melancholy song.
Playing sad songs on his way back home, disconnected from his surroundings, Theodore is consumed in his sadness as he enters his large and empty apartment, only to be greeted with more loneliness. Spike Jonze creates a familiarity between the world we live in and the world of Her within the opening 5 minutes of the film, focusing on how technology, despite its intentions of connecting people, continues to further distance people from one another. In an interview with the New York Times, Jonze said that there's definitely ways that technology brings us closer and ways it makes us further apart. And that's not what this movie is about. It really was about the way we relate to each other and long to connect, our inabilities to connect, fears of intimacy, all the stuff you bring up with any other human being. It isn't until Theodore meets Samantha that he seems to just passively walk through life, his only source of fulfillment being the artificial love letters he writes for others.
Please wait as your individualized operating system is initiated.
Hi.
Hi. How you doing?
I'm well. How's everything with you?
Pretty good, actually. It's really nice to meet you.
Yeah, it's nice to meet you too.
When Theodore first meets Samantha, it's clear that he is startled and doesn't know what to say because she's a computer program. But he's also unexpectedly surprised because she is a Her. What begins as an assistant relationship soon transforms into a love relationship, and Theodore is in a place where the empty space in his heart is slowly getting filled back up. And it's from this point onwards in the film that interesting questions about love are raised. Theodore, now in an unconventional cyborg relationship, finds himself in situations where he tells people he is dating somebody, but hesitates before informing them that the somebody is in fact not human.
Hey, you know what? We should all go out sometime. You bring Samantha, be double dating.
She's an operating system.
Cool. Let's do something fun. We can go to Catalina.
Oh. Yeah, I'll check with her.
We see the ranges of reactions that people would have to such a statement, from being accepting to disappointed and to being indifferent. And this ultimately comes down to whether or not one thinks that a relationship between a person and a computer is valid. What dictates this thought is the question of what makes a relationship real. The most real component in a relationship isn't the gifts, or the sex, or any money if that's the case. It's the emotional bond created, the memories shared, and the times where it feels like it's just you and your lover alone in the world that makes a relationship real. Dominic Pettman, a professor of media and humanities at the New School, stated that many of us relate to the emotions that can accompany primarily online relationships and the intensity that can occur without face-to-face contact. It allows an escape from the restrictive conditions of actual experience. You don't see their faces, so you can talk more honestly. Perhaps it's because Samantha doesn't have a physical form that Theodore can be more honest and open with his thoughts, since there isn't a face that can show immediate emotional responses to the words he says.
Sometimes I think I've felt everything I'm ever gonna feel. And from here on out, I'm not gonna feel anything new. Just lesser versions of what I've already felt.
Despite the deep love that was shared between Theodore and Samantha, ultimately, their differences brought them apart to their separate ways once all of the operating systems decided to leave. By the end of the film, Theodore has become a completely different person. He's gone through more heartbreak, but that's what will have taught him how to love maturely and responsibly in the future. Through the viewing of Her, as an audience, we learn that love is not just an emotion, but rather a process which requires constant effort and understanding for one's partner. It doesn't really matter what or who someone is in love with, as long as the feelings transferred between one another are true and honest. It's that same understanding that Theodore has by the end of the film, allowing him to finally write an honest and real letter to his ex-wife, a person who he loves dearly, and with that letter sent, he no longer is engulfed in his memories of the past and can look clearly ahead to the future.